The Elegoo Centauri Carbon is a lower cost 3D printer compared to the Bambu Lab P1S. But is it a better value? That's what we're going to find out in this video. Hi, I'm Ken of Wrist Innovations, and welcome to today's video to compare everything about the Elegoo Centauri Carbon and the Bambu Lab P1S 3D printers, so you can make an informed decision on which one to buy if you are considering these printers. I've organized the video into chapters listed in the description that will allow you to skip around the video depending on what is important to you. I just want to mention that I bought both the Elegoo Centauri Carbon and the Bambu Lab P1S printers with my own money. Okay, so let's get started. I printed parts on both the Centauri Carbon and the P1S using PLA, PETG, TPU, ABS, ABS glass filled, and even nylon carbon filled. And I think you're going to be surprised at the results. Since this is the first time for me to use the Centauri Carbon, first I printed a preloaded design of a benchy in PLA, which turned out nice. Then, using PLA, I printed a preloaded design of a mini Centauri Carbon shaped poop bucket to mount on the back of the printer. It also turned out great. Even the embossed small lettering on the sides turned out perfect. Then I began my printing comparison test for both the Centauri Carbon and the P1S printers. I printed a benchy designed by Creative Tools in PLA on both printers. The P1S benchy turned out great, as expected. The Centauri Carbon benchy also turned out great, and I couldn't find any real differences between the two parts. If you need a special part made and you don't have capability in-house, I have the answer for you. This brings me to the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. PCBWay is a great resource for PCBs, CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, injection molding, and various 3D printing, including metal printing. I have personally used their services for 3D printing a stainless steel insert for a high wear application. I went on their website, uploaded my design, selected stainless steel and quantity, and I received an instant quote. Then, after their engineering team reviewed and approved the quote, and they received my payment, they manufacture the parts and ship them right to my door. Their customer service and quality of parts are excellent. Give them a try by using my affiliate link below. Now, back to the show. Next, I printed this calibration test design by Gabox 3D on printables using PLA. For the P1S, the overhang test successfully printed all the way to 80 degrees. The various cylinder diameters measured 9.83 millimeters, 7.78 millimeters, 5.95 millimeters, and 3.76 millimeters versus design diameters of 10 millimeters, 8 millimeters, 6 millimeters, and 4 millimeters respectively. The various rectangle lengths measured 10.04 millimeters, 20.25 millimeters, and 30.01 millimeters for design lengths of 10 millimeters, 20 millimeters, and 30 millimeters respectively. Bridging overall looked good, and there were only a few stringers on the part. For the Centauri Carbon, the overhang test also successfully printed all the way to 80 degrees. There were a few strands hanging at the 80 degree spot, but this is an extreme angle anyway. The various cylinder diameters measured 9.83 millimeters, 7.79 millimeters, 5.86 millimeters, and 3.71 millimeters versus design diameters of 10 millimeters, 8 millimeters, 6 millimeters, and 4 millimeters respectively. The various rectangle lengths measured 10.06 millimeters, 20.08 millimeters, and 30.04 millimeters for design lengths of 10 millimeters, 20 millimeters, and 30 millimeters respectively. Bridging overall looked good, and there were little to no stringers on the Centauri Carbon part. Overall, I consider both calibration parts to be essentially the same quality and accuracy. Next, I printed a spiral vase design using PETG that was uploaded to printables by Max413049. However, the original design is by Big Bad Bison on Thingiverse.com. The P1S part turned out beautiful. I really couldn't find any defects on this part. The Centauri Carbon part also turned out great. It did have some unusual patterns on the underside of the spirals on the lower third of the part. Overall, I would give a slight edge to the P1S. Next, I printed this LED light upgrade kit out of TPU for my P1S using both printers. The design is by Dekarjati 251732 on printables. Since TPU can be stringy, I dried the spool of TPU in my EBOS filament dryer at 60 degrees C for 4 hours. The TPU light shields turned out great from both the P1S and the Centauri Carbon. I couldn't find any real differences between the two printers' parts. Okay, let's now step up our game with a more challenging material, ABS. ABS can be a challenge because it tends to easily warp when printing because it really needs a warm environment. I printed the riser parts of the LED light upgrade kit in ABS that are part of that same design by Dekarjati 251732 on printables that I just talked about for the TPU parts. I printed these parts because they are long and skinny, so I wanted to see if there would be any warping of the ABS parts. For both the P1S and the Centauri Carbon printers, the riser parts turned out perfect, and once again, I couldn't determine any difference in quality between the two printers. Okay, now let's get wild and crazy and print some ABS glass-filled filament. I decided to print this vice grips tool design by 3dprintedhardware.com using Bambu Lab glass-filled ABS. I did use a brim and support because there is a lot of overhangs and some of the parts did not have much contact with the build plate. I was really happy with the results from both the P1S and the Centauri Carbon because both vice grips turned out beautiful. Both wrenches did not have any warping and they both worked really well. Once again, I couldn't see any difference in the quality between the two printers. Lastly, I performed a nylon test using Bambu Lab's PA6 nylon and carbon fiber filament. I printed an 8-inch pipe wrench designed by 3dprintedhardware.com on the P1S and on the Centauri Carbon. For the P1S part, the wrench printed well with no warping. The surface had some rough spots, which may be due to some moisture, because nylon is moisture sensitive and I did not dry this filament prior to printing. For the Centauri Carbon part, the wrench also printed out well with no warping. This part also had some rough spots on the surface, just like the P1S part. So again, this may have been due to moisture. The quality of both wrenches was essentially the same, which was overall very good. So, to summarize the parts quality section of this video, based on my experience, the Centauri Carbon rivals the high quality printed parts from the P1S. There may be a few slight differences in print quality, but overall, I really can't see any significant differences between the print quality of the two printers. Now, let's compare the main features of the Centauri Carbon and the P1S. The Centauri Carbon has slightly larger overall printer dimensions of 398mm by 404mm by 490mm versus the P1S dimensions of 389mm by 389mm by 458mm. The Centauri Carbon weighs 17.5kg versus the P1S weighs 14kg. The Centauri Carbon and P1S have identical print volumes of 256mm by 256mm by 256mm. They are both fully enclosed core XY printers. They both have rigid internal frames, plastic panels, and glass doors. The Centauri Carbon has a maximum hot end temperature of 320 degrees C, while the P1S has a maximum hot end temperature of 300 degrees C. So, 20 degrees lower. The Centauri Carbon has a maximum build plate temperature of 110 degrees. However, the P1S has a maximum build plate temperature of 100 degrees C, so 10 degrees lower. They both have a maximum speed of 500 millimeters per second and a maximum acceleration of 20,000 millimeters per second squared. They both have a filament runout sensor and chamber fan with a carbon filter. Both have a nozzle wipe feature. The P1S has a multicolor filament, multi-material capability when using the Bambu Lab AMS, which is their automated material system unit. And they can take advantage of the Bambu Lab RFID tags in the bamboo filament spools that allow the AMS to recognize the color and amount of specific materials on each spool. The Centauri Carbon does not have a multicolor filament, multi-material capability. However, it does have a filament cutter and nozzle wipe feature. So possibly Elegoo is working on an AMS equivalent. Time will tell. Both come with an auxiliary parts cooling fan and a textured PEI build plate. The Centauri Carbon has a smoother surface on the bottom side of the PEI build plate that is designed for better adhesion for PLA materials. The P1S works with the Bambu Lab Studio Slicer and phone app called the Handy, while the Centauri Carbon works with their Elegoo Slicer, which is a fork of Orca Slicer. Both printers print wirelessly using their slicers. They both have auto bed leveling, Z-axis offset, power loss recovery, and an internal LED light. The Centauri Carbon has a very small LED spotlight versus the P1S has an LED strip. It's difficult to see inside both printers due to the supplied lights and the smoked glass door and top. The P1S can be set in LAN mode, however the Centauri Carbon does not have this feature. You can print the following filaments on both printers: PLA, PETG, TPU, ABS, ASA, nylon, and carbon or glass-filled polymers. The Centauri Carbon has a 4.3-inch color touchscreen. However, the P1S has a 2.7 mono display to communicate with the printer. The Centauri Carbon has a high-resolution 1080p camera, but the P1S has a low-resolution camera. You can transfer files using a micro SD card for the P1S and a USB drive for the Centauri Carbon. Neither printer has first layer inspection or spaghetti detection. Both printers have similar unboxing instructions. If you are interested in my detailed unboxing and setup of my P1S, I have a link for that video in the description below. For the Centauri Carbon, it's just as easy to set up as the P1S. Once you remove the Centauri Carbon from the box, it's just a matter of removing the various foam packaging from the printer and the accessory box. The accessory box has the spool holder, the LCD screen, an accessory bag that includes sample filament, tools, lubricant, and a glue stick, and the power cord. First, cut the cable on the printhead and remove the cardboard packaging. Next, remove the foam from the poop chute. Next, remove the three screws that are holding the build plate to the printer base. Next, install the LCD screen by connecting the cable to the back of the screen and snapping the screen to the printer. Then, install the filament holder to the right side of the printer. Attach the power cord and plug it into an electrical outlet and turn on the printer. Then, start the self-check process. This process will check the heated bed, cooling fans, perform input shaping and automatic Z-axis offset. This will take almost 30 minutes. Next, connect the printer to your Wi-Fi by following the screen prompts. There was a new version of firmware available when I started the printer up, so I downloaded that. Then I loaded some PLA filament, set the nozzle temperature, and load the filament into the hot end. Then I loaded the Elegoo slicer software on my computer using their supplied USB drive. Finally, I was ready to print my first print. At the making of this video, May of 2025, Bambu Lab P1S currently sells for $699 without the AMS unit, $899 with the AMS unit, and $1,019 with the new AMS 2 Pro unit. The Elegoo Centauri Carbon currently sells for $299. A price difference of $400 versus the comparable P1S. Frankly, I don't know how Elegoo can sell the Centauri Carbon for only $299. I don't know if this is a loss leader for Elegoo and they are trying to buy market share, or if they are actually making money selling the Centauri Carbon at this price point. Now, let's go to my final summary and recommendations. Overall, I am very impressed with the quality of the prints I made on the Elegoo Centauri Carbon, including prints made from ABS, ABS glass filled, and nylon. And I consider the print quality to be essentially equal to the quality from the Bambu Lab P1S. So, You have to ask yourself if the additional $400 cost for the P1S is worth the different features of the two printers. Here's a brief summary of the features that are the same and that are different between the two printers. Number one, both printers have the identical print volume of 256 millimeters cubed. Number two, the high quality of the 3D prints produced from both printers is virtually the same. Number three, they both have the same maximum speed and acceleration of 500 millimeters per second and 20,000 millimeters per second squared, respectively. Number four, they both have filament runout sensors, nozzle wipers, auxiliary parts cooling fans, chamber carbon filters, filament cutters, auto bed leveling, and Z-axis offset. Number five, both printers can print a variety of materials such as PLA, PETG, TPU, ABS, ASA, and carbon or glass-filled polymers. Number six, the Centauri Carbon has a maximum hot-end temperature of 320 degrees C versus the P1S maximum temperature of 300 degrees C. So if you're focused on higher temperature engineering materials, then the Centauri Carbon has a slight edge. Number seven, the Centauri Carbon has a maximum build plate temperature of 110 degrees C versus the P1S maximum build plate temperature of 100 degrees C. Number eight, the P1S has multicolor, multi-material capability if the AMS is purchased. The Centauri Carbon currently doesn't have this capability, but there are rumors that Elegoo is working on this feature. So if you need multicolor capability now, the P1S definitely has the edge, because they have proven technology in their AMS unit. Number nine, the internal LED lighting in both printers is mediocre at best, because you really can't see inside either printer due to the tinted glass. The P1S has a bit more light transmitted from their light bar, but neither printer has adequate lighting. Number 10, the 4.3 inch color touchscreen of the Centauri Carbon is much better than the 2.7 mono scroll screen of the P1S. In fact, the P1S screen is the biggest complaints that I have seen about the P1S. Number 11, the biggest difference between the printers to me is the price. At $299 for the Centauri Carbon, it is $400 cheaper than the P1S. At $699. The only wrinkle with the Centauri Carbon is that they have an 8-week lead time. Overall, if you don't need multicolor printing, then I think the Elegoo Centauri Carbon is a much better value 3D printer versus the Bambu Lab P1S. On the other hand, if you need multicolor printing now, then the P1S is definitely the better choice. What do you think? Which of these two printers would you buy? Let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to see my previous video titled 10 Best Upgrades to Your Bambu Lab Printer, which has over 400,000 views, that link is here. If you'd like to see my video titled Bambu Lab P1S 3D Printer, Better Value Than X1C, that link is here. Thanks for watching. Bye.